Welcome. I'm Sheriff Dave Hutchinson of the Hempstead County Sheriff's Office. Will you please join me for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Detention Deputy Mark Mattson will now perform the National Anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Today is May 15th, which has been recognized as National Police Officers Memorial Day since 1962. And this week has been recognized as National Police Week. In normal years, we would have gathered alongside the Minneapolis Police Department to remember those who have bravely given their lives for this honor and noble profession. However, National Police Week activities have been canceled due to COVID-19. And we have decided to follow that example. But we cannot let the sacrifices of our brave men and women go unrecognized. So this year, we will honor them in this video and hopefully gather again in person next year. Please join us as we read the names of the fallen. Thank their loved ones and send our condolences for those who carry the weight and the sacrifice each and every day. We'll begin with an invocation from Chaplain Dave Larson, who served as a spiritual resource to the men and women of the Hempstead County Sheriff's Office as a part of our internal wellness unit.
Hi, I'm Chaplain Dave Larson, one of the members of the Hempstead County Sheriff's Office Tri-Wellness Unit. First and foremost, I want to extend my deepest sympathies and condolences to all of you, to the family members, to the co-workers, to the friends. Today, as you remember and continue to grieve the loss of someone who is so near and dear to you, events like these can be very challenging because in events like these, we remember that people that meant so much to us are no longer with us. But events like these can also be very encouraging and uplifting and healing, because as we remember them, we remember their lives, their legacies, and the impact that they've had on us as individuals, but also upon the neighborhoods in which they served and the departments that they served in as well. And so I pray for all of you that this event, that this time, even though we can't do it as we normally do it, that even though we can't meet together to remember our loved ones in person together, that we can remember their lives and legacies in person together, that even though we're doing it a different way, I do pray that this event would be a source of healing, a source of blessing, and a source of comfort to all of you. I encourage you and invite you to pray with me. Dear God, on this day I pray for all of these families, for all of these co-workers who remember those that have gone before us, these individuals who served their communities, these individuals who loved their families, these individuals who showed and exemplified courage and bravery. Lord, as we remember their lives, their legacies, the impacts that they've had on us, I ask that we would be blessed and uplifted as we remember them and their lives. And that even now, as we live our lives, that their lives, their legacies would continue to be at work in us and through us and how we live and how we go about our work and how we treat others. Lord, again, I ask that this time would be a blessing, a source of encouragement and continued healing for all of us. I pray this in your name. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Dave. Next, a brief message from our mayor, Jacob Fry. In my time as sheriff, Mayor Fry has proven himself as an effective and reliable partner. He understands the importance for strong public safety and public safety services. The relationship between Minneapolis and the sheriff's office has never been better. We are pleased to have him speak with us today.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Sheriff Hutchison, for that warm introduction, like so many of our traditions. Recognizing National Peace Officers Memorial Day looks dramatically different this year. However, it is still important for us to honor those who have made the deepest sacrifice. With deep gratitude, we thank you, both for your service and sacrifice. We recognize that in current times, you all face an even bigger risk in an invisible threat that is COVID-19. Yet you all continue to show up day in, day out, do your jobs, keeping our communities safe. Thank you for all that you do. Today, we would like to recognize and honor those who have given the ultimate sacrifice to our communities for our collective safety in Minneapolis and in Hennepin County. Few professionals are as selfless as our first responders, those who run toward danger instead of away from it, with a mission to protect those who are in need, many times during their very darkest hours. Law enforcement is a noble profession, and one that deserves our respect, our recognition, and our thanks throughout the year, not just during Police Week. We're incredibly lucky to have the best law enforcement agencies in the state right here in our Minneapolis Police Department and our Hennepin County Sheriff's Office. I'd also like to argue we've got some of the very best in the entire nation right here. We've asked a lot of our peace officers, and the list of duties seemingly only continues to grow. You're not just officers, but social workers, mentors, coaches, diplomats, counselors, and many other roles that are all wrapped up into wearing that badge that you wear. So you're on the front lines day in and day out, upholding the law, delivering justice. There's not enough thanks to capture all of what you're doing, especially right now. So let us recognize those whose lives work is focused on making our communities safer. And in doing so, honor those who have given the ultimate sacrifice, our fallen heroes, today and every day. May they rest in peace. May they rest in honor.
Thank you, Mayor Fry. And thank you all for joining the Hennepin County Sheriff's Office, Minneapolis Police Department today as we honor those who have given their lives in the line of duty. It has been an exceptionally challenging year for the world, our country. The past several months in particular have demonstrated the importance of service. Around the country, people are asking themselves, what can they do to help their fellow citizens who are in need? This is a question that the men and women ask themselves every day in times of crisis and times of peace. Dedication to service is what truly makes an officer a public servant. And now a message from U.S. Attorney Erica McDonald.
Each year, during National Police Week, we commemorate the courage, the sense of duty, and the strength of character that this noble profession mandates. We are forever grateful to the men and women in law enforcement who continue to serve our nation during this difficult time. Sadly, this week also marks the time to honor and pay tribute to the 307 men and women whose names are engraved in 2020 on the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial. We are forever grateful to the fallen officers, their colleagues, and their families for their service and their sacrifice. Thank you to all of law enforcement, and God bless.
Thank you, Erica. Today we are here to remember the fallen. With the utmost respect and gratitude, we pay tribute to their sacrifice. It is my pleasure to introduce Minneapolis Police Chief Arredondo. He joined the Minneapolis Police Department in 1989 as a patrol officer patrolling the north side. He's worked his way up to inspector of downtown in 2013. In 2017, he was nominated to become the 53rd Chief of Police of Minneapolis by Mayor Fry. I'm proud to call him a partner and a friend.
Thank you, Sheriff Hutchinson, Mayor Fry, and all of our law enforcement officers and partners. During these unprecedented times, I'm reminded daily of the dedication and commitment to the public from our officers. One of the greatest gifts we can give is our service to others. And today, during National Law Enforcement Week, we recognize the officers who have given the greatest gift of service, their life, in the line of duty. We do so with humbled and distinguished honor. Your service, your commitment, and your ultimate sacrifice will never, ever be forgotten. We also send our heartfelt condolences to their loved ones who feel that ultimate sacrifice every day. We know that law enforcement is a calling, and most importantly, a duty entrusted upon us by those we swear to protect and serve. Today, more than ever, we all come together to honor and remember these fallen officers, and we continue to work for stronger and safer communities for all. We will now have the roll call for the officers that have made the ultimate sacrifice.
Robert Laughlin, July 28, 1884, Minneapolis Police Department. Charles Channels, May 27, 1906, Minneapolis Police Department. Joseph Olinger, July 15, 1911, Minneapolis Police Department. William Lydon, November 25, 1913, Minneapolis Police Department. George Anderson, November 28, 1913, Minneapolis Police Department. Otto Osby, May 19, 1915, Minneapolis Police Department. Nels Anderson, May 31st, 1916, Minneapolis Police Department. James Gardner, November 1st, 1916, Osseo Police Department. George Connery, April 24th, 1917, Minneapolis Police Department. James Burt Ware, February 7th, 1919, Minneapolis Police Department. George Wozner, June 24th, 1919, Minneapolis Police Department. John Young, July 13th, 1919, Minneapolis Police Department. Frank Hallett, August 25th, 1920, Minneapolis Police Department. John Foley, October 26th, 1921, Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. Emma Langstrom, August 14th, 1923, Minneapolis Police Department. Murdoch Murray, October 21st, 1925, alcohol, tobacco, and firearms. Mike Lawrence, December 30th, 1925, Minneapolis Police Department. Wesley Frazier, January 2nd, 1928, alcohol, tobacco, and firearms. Albert Anderson, February 1st, 1928, Minneapolis Police Department. Clayton Sewell, May 4th, 1929, Minneapolis Police Department. Harry Parker, December 24th, 1930, Minneapolis Police Department. Harry McGraw, February 1st, 1931, Minneapolis Police Department. Clayton Olson, August 9th, 1931, Minneapolis Police Department. Harold Hagen, August 3rd, 1932, Minneapolis Police Department. James Harney, September 23rd, 1932, alcohol, tobacco, and firearms. Ira Evans, December 16th, 1932, Minneapolis Police Department. Leo Gorski, December 18th, 1932, Minneapolis Police Department. John Thomas, August 5th, 1933, Minneapolis Police Department. C. Arthur Lyman, May 22nd, 1934, Hennepin County Sheriff's Office. Peter Erath, May 26th, 1934, Minneapolis Police Department. Ben Lehman, May 3rd, 1936, Minneapolis Police Department. Georgiana Sherritt, June 14th, 1937, Minneapolis Police Department. James Trepanier, September 20th, 1930, Minneapolis Police Department. John Garrity, July 10th, 1939, Minneapolis Police Department. Adolf Karpinski, May 22nd, 1941, Minneapolis Police Department. Harold Olson, August 9th, 1941, Minneapolis Police Department. John O'Neill, July 7th, 1944, Minneapolis Police Department. Marvin Wicklin, June 6th, 1945, Minneapolis Police Department. Fred Babcock, June 4th, 1949, Richfield Police Department. Donald McHale, March 25th, 1951, Minneapolis Police Department. Donald Risberg, November 28th, 1956, Minneapolis Police Department. Robert Fossum, August 17th, 1957, Minneapolis Police Department. Leo Bessner, May 12th, 1958, Minneapolis Police Department. William Herkel, May 11th, 1959, Minneapolis Police Department. Andrew Pete Sharp, August 17th, 1963, Minneapolis Police Department. James Hendricks, December 15th, 1963, Minneapolis Police Department. Lloyd Reed, August 6th, 1965, Minneapolis Police Department. Richard Bergquist, April 7th, 1969, Minneapolis Police Department. Rodney Norberg, August 13th, 1971, Hennepin County Sheriff's Office. Joseph Pudlick, February 4th, 1972, Minneapolis Police Department. Eno Suick, September 30th, 1972, Minneapolis Police Department. George Partridge, May 26th, 1976, Minneapolis Police Department. Mark Kirkland, August 25th, 1977, Federal Bureau of Investigations. Trenwith Basford, August 25th, 1977, Federal Bureau of Investigations. Michael Kassman, May 4th, 1979, Minneapolis Police Department. Richard Miller, August 25th, 1981, Minneapolis Police Department. James William Anderson, August 31st, 1982, Wayzata Police Department. John Scanlon, February 14th, 1985, Robbinsdale Police Department. David Mack, November 2nd, 1986, Minneapolis Police Department. William Goodsell, November 19th, 1986, Minneapolis Park Police. Henry Carlson, June 20th, 1991, United States Marshal. Jerome Hoff, September 25th, 1992, Minneapolis Police Department. Paul Moen, July 1st, 1995, Minneapolis Police Department. Ward Canfield, March 2nd, 2000, Minneapolis Police Department. Melissa Schmidt, August 1st, 2002, Minneapolis Police Department. Lisa Kern, July 11th, 2004, Minneapolis Police Department. Mark Bedard, November 9th, 2007, Minneapolis Park Police. David Leffler, May 29th, 2009, Minneapolis Police Department. Mike Politz, November 30th, 2011, St. Louis Park Police Department. And William Matthews, September 8th, 2017, Wayzata Police Department.
Thank you all for joining us today for this video to pay tribute to those who have made the ultimate sacrifice. We appreciate your support. We look forward to once again gathering in person to recognize our fallen brothers and sisters. Be well and take care of one another.